Hello again. Good to be with you. Bill Pfeiffer speaking from Mary's Field. It's a new year. A good time for resolutions. Try if you can to not be overexcited about making resolutions. You want to end up trying to do maybe just one thing in the course of the next 12 months. If you decide to do two or three, usually what happens is nothing really occurs. If you can choose one, maybe you can focus in on that, the thing that you need most in your life at this point. As I mentioned to my students in school, I used to say to them, gee, suppose your mom is 50 or your dad, they were able to, since they're only 25, just make one resolution and carry that out for a year and then kind of encourage it each year, they'd have 25 things in their lives that they have begun to do or have stopped doing. And that's a lot of things. It's just that we kind of drop them by Valentine's Day, it's all over. But the important thing is to keep repeating things. If you want to change your life, if you want to become all that God is calling you to be, the one thing that you have to do, and there's no excuses, there's no way around it, is you got to acquire a prayer life during this year, one that is more than just the Hail Mary, Our Father, Rosary kind of prayer life, but one that includes silence. Silence is really important because in those moments of silence, God's able to get to you inside of yourself to the places that need transformation and change in your life to make space for God to be there. And you'll end up finding out all kinds of wonderful things about yourself or some of the things that get in the way of your own happiness. And then transformation begins and you're able to touch the people around you and be able to do things for the culture in which you live. I mean, you can't beat that, but you can't avoid doing it. That's the only way that I know that it actually happens, and it takes time. You have to spend time. You have to somehow learn how to waste time with God. You have to become a thief. You have to steal time, a holy thievery, if you will, and you have to be able to do that so that you can get away from the television for 20 minutes in the morning or 20 minutes in the afternoon. Get up 20 minutes earlier and be able to spend quiet time, centering prayer time. The place to go is Contemplative Prayer Outreach, and it's a simple, very, very simple thing. But it's in silence that God speaks. Silence is God's first language. Anything else is a bad translation. So take time. You know, time is given to us, fresh time, to change and to grow, nothing more. That's why we have time. That's why we exist on this planet for 70 or 80 or 90 years. I'm 84 and I've existed. It's been a time for change so that I can be transformed and become more like God, more like Jesus. That's really the reason why we exist on this planet, to know Him, to love Him, to serve Him in this world, and to be happy for Him forever in heaven. And that's the purpose for our existence. You know, we keep losing the insider wisdom, and we fill it with all other kinds of things that then distract us so much that it's very difficult to get back to the prime motive, the prime reason why we exist. So you want to become all that you're called to be, you got to do the things that you have to do to make that happen. And it takes time, it takes effort, and it's not an easy thing. It takes work. It's a difficult thing, acquiring and developing a spiritual life. But there's nothing like it. You end up trusting God, and once you trust God, you have no more worries. Isn't that the thing that you'd like to be able to say? I don't have any more worries. You know, I trust God. What a marvelous thing that would be. So, you want to take time. You know, there's a nice thing I used to read to my students in school. Take time to think. You know, it's the source of power. Take time to play. It's the secret of perpetual youth. Leisure is an important part of our lives. Take time to read. It's the fountain of wisdom. You have to have some spiritual reading in your life. You have to certainly read the scriptures, but it's good to have another book. Right now, I'm reading Richard Rohr's The Divine Dance. It's truly in the top three of my life. It's a life-changing book, and without that, I can't grow. Without those ideas constantly coming in, you know. So take time to read. It's a fountain of prayer. Take time to pray. It's the greatest power on earth. It is. I mean, there's nothing, you can't substitute for it. If you really want to develop a spiritual life, it's the food that you need, and you either starve or you eat, and it's one or the other. Huh? Take time to love and be loved. It is a God-given privilege. Take time to be friendly. It's the road to happiness. Take time to laugh. It's the music for the soul. What a nice thing that is. Huh? What a nice thought that is. Take time to give. It's too short a day to be selfish. Take time to work. It's the price of success. Take time to do charity. It's the key to heaven. So, you know, more people are going to die in the year 2022 from stress and anxiety and worry and overwork than they will of cancer. And you know that. That's the truth. And you don't want to be one of those victims. You want to end up making this be a year of real life and growth. If you're a teacher, here's the thing that I used to read to myself. One of the nice things about being a teacher is you get two New Years, one in September when you start fresh for the school year, and then in January you kind of get another year, which is really nice. But here's a nice a word for any teachers that are out there. When you've mastered all the methods, penetrated all the ways, wherein those who are successful justify their claims to praise. Very precious the possession of the technique and art, but you cannot substitute it for a sympathetic heart. Learning will be useless lumber if you cannot make you see that the verb to know is never greater than the verb to be. So take heed to what you're saying, for your pupils, wiser far, will be thinking while you say it, of the kind of person you are. It's one of the reasons I tell the stories. Immediately, the students, by telling the story, at the same time, they knew what I valued, they knew what I didn't value, they knew what I thought was really important, and I didn't have to say a thing. I just told the stories. What an easy thing. And the neat thing is I'd get a double benefit, because they'd go home and tell their parents at supper time the stories. And what a nice thing. So you end up, you know, sharing this in here. 'Tis the understanding spirit, the soul resolved to give, and the love behind the lesson that makes a lesson live. Garner every bit of knowledge as the miser would this pelf, but remember that the core of all your teaching is yourself. And that's true. It's so difficult. Whenever I would speak to groups of teachers, I would try to help them to understand that. But it's very difficult because teaching is so demanding these days and so time-consuming that people didn't almost want to hear the message that you got to do stuff primarily to take care of yourself. And that just ends up oozing out in the classroom and transforming the students before you. Why you don't know you're doing it. That's really the best of all worlds. So at any rate, nothing ever changes unless you and I change. So if you want to be happy tomorrow, if you want to change people tomorrow, you have to do the truth today. And a part of that is a serious life of change and prayer. Transformed people transform people. Untransformed people don't transform people. It's a simple thing. It's a message. Nemo dot quod non habet. No one gives what he doesn't have. You don't have $5, you can't give it. You don't have happiness or peace or joy or wholeness or freedom, you can't share that. And you really want to be a sharer of that in the year 2022. God bless. Good to be with you. Keep me in your thoughts and prayers. Know that you're in mine.